Video is all about Bluetooth. Now nearly all of you will have heard of Bluetooth, know what it is and used it regularly. So what is it? Well, Bluetooth is a way of transferring information over short distances without using wires. Now it's available on nearly all mobile devices. Now I covered Wi-Fi Direct in episode 2, which does the same job, however in a shorter timescale and over longer distances. However, more people probably know about Bluetooth because it's been around for longer and is available in nearly all tech products, from printers, keyboards and laptops to TVs and alarm clocks. Okay, so I'll show you an example of how Bluetooth works using my Nexus 4 and Samsung Galaxy Note 2. So if you go to your settings and click on Bluetooth, there we are, Bluetooth, and if you turn your Bluetooth on, like so, okay, now you can change the name of your Bluetooth. As you can see, I've changed mine to Android Simplified. You do it just by clicking on the menu button here, click on Rename Device, and then just type in your new name. And it's that simple. Now, I've also turned my Bluetooth on my Nexus 4, but I can't start transferring files at this point. Now, this is because the default setting for my Bluetooth is to be hidden from other Bluetooth devices, and for this reason, my Nexus 4 won't be able to find my Note 2 if I scan for it, as you can see here, as there's no available devices listed. And it's the same thing on this side. My Note 2 won't be able to find my Nexus 4, as you can see here, because the default settings for the Bluetooth is to be hidden from other Bluetooth devices. So what I need to do is check this box here. Okay, and the same thing on this phone. If you're just tapping it. Now, as you can see, a countdown has begun. And as it begins, as you can see, it's signifying the length of time for which your Bluetooth will stay visible. And when it expires, it will go back to a hidden state. So just in case you can't see that, it's there, 137, 136, 135, and the same on this device, 137, 136, 135. So it's counting down on both devices. Okay, now this is actually a very secure safety feature and also a battery conserving feature, although obviously it's best to keep your Bluetooth off until you plan to use it. Now if you want to change the length of the Bluetooth timeout, you can press the options button here, okay, and on visible timeout, and you have a choice here, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 1 hour, never timeout. So you can choose any of these options and then it will change the countdown timer. If you click on never timeout, obviously it will stop it from timing out at all. Now obviously this process does vary slightly for each Android device, but it will be very similar. Once we made the Bluetooth visible on both devices, as you can see here, the Nexus 4 is showing up on the Galaxy Note 2, and the same over here. The Androids, it says Android Simplified, which is the Galaxy Note 2 device, so it is showing up on the Nexus 4. So how do we go about pairing both phones? So what you need to do is if you click on the device name on one of the phones, either one you can choose, now it will start pairing it, and this is the message that you'll get. It's a pairing request on both phones. Now you do need to confirm on both phones, so you'd have to click OK here and pair here, but what you need to do before you do that is it does ask you to confirm the passkey. So it's 744078, make sure it's the same on the other side, which it is. So if we click on pair here and we click on OK here, as you can see, they're pairing up, yep, and they're both paired. So now the devices have paired up and we can start transferring files. Okay, so to send a picture, for instance, I've gone to my gallery here on my Samsung Galaxy Note 2 and I've picked this photo of my Nokia Lumia. Now this is the media file that I'm going to send across to my Nexus 4 via Bluetooth. So how to do that? If I click on the share icon here, it gives me a list of different ways in which I can share this media file. However, I want to do it via Bluetooth, so if I just click on Bluetooth here, now it tells me that I'm paired up to my Nexus 4 device. So if I just click here, now it will tell me that it's sending the file to the Nexus 4. However, you won't yet receive the file on your Nexus 4 until you accept it and let your phone know that you do in fact want to receive this incoming file. So it sent me an alert here. It says, do you want to receive this file? Android Simplified wants to send you this media file. Accept the file, decline or accept. So if I click on accept here, now the transfer is going through. Now it's almost identical to the process of Wi-Fi Direct, and as you can see, it does take a bit of time for the file to transfer, so it's not as quick. Okay, so if we go back onto this screen on my Samsung Galaxy Note 2, just a few more features I want to show you. If you click on the options button here and go to received files, any received files you've ever had on your Samsung Galaxy Note 2 will be shown up here. So if you want to access a file quickly, rather than going to through your gallery for a picture or a video, or through your documents for a document that's been sent via Bluetooth, you can just go onto here, onto your Bluetooth settings, click on your options, click on received files, and they'll be listed here. I think it's quite handy that they've done that, even though people don't really tend to use Bluetooth as much anymore. But if you do use it and you find it quite useful, then it's just a nice little feature to have. Okay, now something else I'd like to point out as well. On the Nexus 4, it says paired, and it also gives you this option here to go on to further settings for your Nexus 4. Now you can actually rename the device. It doesn't have to be Nexus 4. Just because the other person has decided, whoever you're pairing up with, has decided to name it Nexus 4, for instance, in this case, it doesn't mean that you have to keep it. So if it was your dad's phone or one of your friend's phone, so if it was my dad's phone, I could write dad and then click on OK. And now for me, every time I pair up to this device, it will be called Dad. If we go back, as you can see, now I'm paired up to Dad. But on the Nexus phone, if we just go onto it, let's go back onto Bluetooth settings. Settings, Bluetooth. As you can see, it's still here. It's called Nexus 4. However, it shows up on my device now as Dad. Okay, so if we go back onto these settings here, make sure you unpair the device once you've sent any media files across, because you don't want the two phones to remain paired up, or any other device that you're using. It doesn't need to remain paired. You can easily, as you've seen, the process is really simple to pair up two devices via Bluetooth. So if you just click on unpair, and as you can see, both devices have now unpaired. Available devices is now the Nokia Lumia and Dad. And on here is Android Simplified, however they're not paired up. And then just turn your Bluetooth off once you're done with it. And that's all you really need to know about Bluetooth. Well, that's the end of episode 5. I hope you've enjoyed it. And if you have any questions or would like me to review an app or explain any features or settings on your mobile device, please leave me a comment and I'll do my best to get a video out. Now, I will be making more episodes, so please subscribe to my channel for my up and coming videos. Thank you for watching.